Good evening, good evening, and welcome to a special CWIT session with the Northern Indiana Chapter of the Lynx. I am Chelsea Whittington, and I have been waiting for this interview for quite some time. In fact, I have even dressed the part as we talk about your upcoming fundraiser. And before we jump into our conversation, I would love for you ladies to introduce yourselves and talk a little bit more about the Lynx and what you do.
Sure, I'll go first. My name is Keisha White, and I serve as the fundraising chair for this year's event, and it happens to be the Kentucky Derby, but please be on the lookout for more from the fundraising committee. But yes, I do serve as the fundraising chair, and I've been a member of the Lynx for 10 plus years now, and I'm glad to serve.
Okay, and Ms. Pritchett.
My name is Alicia Pritchett, and I've been a Lynx since 2012. And I've been president, that I'm serving under my second term as president of the Northern Indiana Chapter of the Lynx Incorporated. I have also served as a former Kentucky Derby chairperson from a previous year. So we're ready to have a lot of fun and get this Derby fundraiser started, so we can raise lots and lots of money for the young kids in our community.
That is wonderful. And I just could recall over the years, because this is the 10th annual Derby, mm-hmm. just seeing the pictures on Facebook, and I have lots of friends who are members of your organization, and I will always, the first word that always comes to mind is, you all are so fancy. And so, Madam President, if you can tell me how the pandemic has impacted the planning of an event that everybody looks forward to, and it being the 10th annual.
Well, we had to, as you know, last year we had to pivot from our plans from the Kentucky Derby. Mm-hmm. We were the first in this region to actually do a virtual fundraiser, whereby we raised netted over $25,500. You were there actually.
Yes.
To help us participate and give out our donations to three worthy organizations. We gave out $8,500 to Sojourner Truth House, the YWMCA, and also to the Northwest Indiana Food Bank. We also gave $3,500 to Brothers Keeper, and that was the start of all of basically dealing with a virtual event.
Mm-hmm. Well, let me say this to you, just for those who are just tuning in and don't recognize, the Lynx, you all really, how can I put this, you all killed the game on the virtual events.
Yeah.
You know, because people go into this with apprehension. The whole technical piece is a separate piece, right?
Mm-hmm.
But to be able to secure high-end names, to engage and have people stay logged on, dancing and donating. I mean, how was the secret? You can tell
Me.
You
can
tell
me. What's the secret sauce? I think the secret sauce is having great committee people, right?
Okay.
There are a lot of people who are on our actual committee who help serve. You've got people like Cynthia Powers, who is a star, rock star.
Totally.
You've got our own Karen Freeman Wilson. Not only our president, you've got Mary Cassie. You've got some big hitters who are out there like really trying to bring in the capacity to make it a worthwhile experience for all. So when you talk about getting big names, you talk about our members who are out there, you know, trying to get into the game and trying to break those barriers and making a name for our Northern Indiana Lynx. And we've been successful at doing that.
Absolutely.
You know, what's been really been popular throughout this whole experience is, you know, the virtual DJing, right?
Yes.
We all know who that one top DJ is. I won't say his name, you know. But I am going to mention DJ Vince Adams.
That's right.
Because he's going to be our DJ for this event.
May 1st.
Yeah, he's coming May 1st. So, you know, we've had committee members work with him. He served as our DJ for last year. He did a phenomenal job in breaking those barriers to party in your purpose at your home, right?
Okay.
So that's how we were able to do that. We've got some great other committee members who have served in the role and just stepping up and doing what needs to be done to make it happen for Northwest Indiana and helping the kids.
Okay, so let's get to the details. If you're just tuning in, where have you been? I am sitting here talking with the ladies of the Northern Indiana Lynx Chapter Incorporated. Chapter of the Lynx Incorporated. I'm gonna shout out my colleague whom I've been working with and my schoolmate, Shay Wright King, get that whole name in there,
yes,
who has been doing the PR for the event. And so we worked together to get the information out. And May 1st, May Day, give me some details, Madam President.
Well, on May 1st, I'm glad you mentioned Shay. Shay was very instrumental as we, when you just, the last question that you just asked about how were we able to carry out a virtual event. And as you well know, there's a lot of technology that's involved,
yes,
in carrying out a virtual event. And Shay was our go-to point person that really did all the planning as far as what was needed to be able to have a virtual event, as well as our other committee members, but she was that go-to person. So we really want to thank her and her public relations team, as well as you know, even your contribution to our event. So we thank you. But getting back to on May 1st, we will start at 3 o'clock. The event will kick off at 3 o'clock. It's from 3 to 6 p.m. Our ticket price is $25, whereby you can go to our website to purchase a ticket, northernindianalinks.com, to purchase a ticket for the event. We also, as what was just mentioned, I'll let Keisha talk about the entertainment, but we also have raffle tickets that will be available. We have $25 raffle tickets, whereby there is 8 items.
Oh, and they have seven items.
Total of 8 items, but for $25, you have a chance at winning a 55 LCD TV. Also, a $1,000 cash prize will be given away. We have a cigar basket.
I was going to say a whole bar.
A cigar basket.
Hey, I want in on that one.
My mind is leaning that way towards normally we always have our bourbon drink.
Yes.
So that's where my mind was leading. But okay, we have a golf foursome, and we will also have that as part of our derby as well, a derby recipe, drink recipe.
Okay.
We have a Traeger grill, freshwater pearl necklace. Also, we have a Tito's basket. And then for $100 raffle ticket, you can
this
get your
the
chance
biggie,
at our the top rated Peloton bike. Very, 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 very popular is the high-rated bike. It's not the lower grade.
Yes,
it's
the high-end
one. The high-end one.
And
correct.
Anybody who follows me knows that that's my new hobby. Over the pandemic, I started to learn how to spin, so I'm like, I want in. I want in on the Peloton.
And the bike will also include spin shoes,
ooh,
as well as 3-pound weights and a 12-month warranty. So you don't want to miss out on the opportunity to, I know Chelsea really wants that bike, but it's open to all. Everybody has a chance of winning that raffle, which is a high-end product.
Okay, so how can they get the tickets? Because I know people are like, wait, Peloton, what?
What? Are you serious? How do you get tickets?
Exactly.
Type in right now, northernindianalinks.com.
You can
go to that website to purchase tickets and to donate for our causes, right? And that's for our youth. We have different facets that we support. Youth and Services, our international. Madam President, please chime in, as I know I will forget some of those facets, but the facets that we'll support in your giving, right? And so when you say that general admission ticket for $25, you're asking yourself, like, what am I going to get? And you alluded to that. So in getting the $25 raffle ticket, you're gonna have an opportunity to really be close and up personal with Damon Williams. He's
awesome.
A fantastic comedian who reigns from Chicago, Illinois, and you all know that he can crack you up at any given time. So be on the lookout for that. Damon Williams will be our entertainment, along with DJ Vince Adams, as the man who will be on the ones and twos. And like our Madam President has said, you know, we're going to have a Tito's invite only, you know.
Yes.
He's going to be mixing some drinks for us, and we're going to be entertaining ourselves in our homes. And the great thing about this virtual event is that you don't need to live here in Indiana.
That's right.
You can roam from Texas. Mm-hmm. You can be from Germany if you want to get up at that time, which we are encouraging people to
please
do.
Please do.
But you can be from Colorado, Hawaii, from wherever, and party with the links. And that's what we want to do.
I love it. And like I said, you all have mastered the game at this. And so I only feel like there's more room for growth when you're able to touch so many different audiences. Although I know that you miss that in-person experience.
Yes.
So I'm thinking as we come out of the pandemic in upcoming months and the year, is there any thought being placed on maybe doing both? You know, I see a lot of organizations now, like, we were so successful with the virtual, maybe we'll have the in-person, but still the virtual piece where people can participate worldwide.
Wow.
And that is the key, what you just said, where we want participation globally, so we can have the both of both worlds.
That's the both
in
worlds.
Person as well as hybrid. When you mentioned, you can see any link member to purchase a raffle ticket. We have different committee members that will have raffle tickets available. We will be selling the raffle tickets in person, so you can see any member of our chapter. We can make sure that you will be able to obtain and purchase a raffle ticket. So
now,
please.
What forms of payment do you accept? So when I call you up and you're on your way, and I'm sitting there with a check, will you be like, no?
Cash and check.
We'll
accept cash and check.
Okay.
Again, because we are still in the pandemic, we want to be careful as far as having a credit card reader or a debit card reader. So right now, cash and check, because we still want to make sure that we are practicing being safe and being in contact with individuals.
Yes.
Yes.
And I understand that we talked about Tito's. Side note, love Tito's. they are one of the key sponsors for the event.
They are the premier sponsor
the
for this
premier
event.
Sponsor.
Yes,
the premier
to
sponsor.
Tito's.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And you know, and trying to get the event together last year, that was the initial thought. You know, we were going to do this fabulous Tito's spin to it with a cigar lounge outside. COVID happened. Right?
All of a sudden.
We could not do anything last year, but we did an awesome outreach for the community in support of over $25,000. Have to tag that again.
That's amazing.
Amazing.
Yes.
So when you talk about wanting to become a sponsor, yes, we do need sponsors,
okay.
Right? So Tito's premier sponsor, $5,000.
Okay.
So if anyone is out there and willing and able to donate $5,000, you're going to get name recognition.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to get talking points like on Facebook Live right now.
Doing like right
exactly.
Now.
You're going to be featured throughout the program, and you're going to be on all of our marketing material that we do have,
which is massive.
Which is massive.
You all are everywhere,
and you know, you are sending things out from CWIT.
Only to about 30,000.
How's about 30,000?
Just a few here and there.
Just a few. But you know what? A few go a long way, and
yes,
30,000 people go a very long way.
Yes.
So we do need sponsorships. We do have other sponsors. Right now, we have Cap Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. They are $1,000 sponsor right now, and we do all have our Divinity Funeral Home in East Chicago, who's a $500 sponsor. We have a couple InCon sponsors. We have Cooley's Video,
West Side.
So we're very thankful for those sponsors. Madam President,
I have to shout out the noobs. I'm sorry, I'm married to one.
He's
thank you,
yeah.
Kappa Brothers.
Yes,
it is the Gary Alumni chapter. We know that
yes.
There's a lot of Kappa chapters in the area. We do want to acknowledge is coming. Those funds were supported by came to us from the Gary Alumni chapter, the Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity.
Nice.
So as well as they also gave a contributed foursome for
yes.
Golf.
Oh, nice.
So they were really
very supportive.
Really,
they were very good supporters.
Generous,
yes.
Very generous in their contribution. But I do want to say, and Linkeisha mentioned some of the areas that we actually service in our community, and we always are about transforming our communities, and that's not only here in Northwest Indiana, which we service Lake Porter, LaPorte County, but also now, as we're going more virtual, we're talking about globally.
Mm-hmm.
And just to give the audience a little information about our chapter, some of our initiatives include our STEM program, which we have, this is our sixth year, partnering with the Gary Community School Corporation at Frankie Woods McCullough Academy. We have won a Best Practice Award a few years ago for our program at that
nice.
School. We know that the kids this year and the funds for our derby goes for scholarship as well as our programs. The kids this year are learning coding, they're learning animation. We're servicing the fifth graders at that school. We also this year just started with our junior NSBE chapter, which would be for the students at the Bowman School in Gary, and that's dealing with engineering. And we're hoping that once we get that program launched, that we will have additional chapters that we can service in the Northwest Indiana, as far as with Hammond, East Chicago, Maryville, even an international chapter we're looking at being able to sponsor.
Wonderful.
So that's really one of our biggest initiatives that we're just starting. We also participate in voter registration drives, and we partner with one of our national partners, which is the NAACP. We also partnered this year with all the fraternities and sororities in this area, as we did Souls to the Polls, to really bring out that vote, which we can tell the results of the election.
Yes.
So we were happy. We are nonpartisan, but we actually want to make sure that everyone basically exercise their civic rights to vote.
Voter education is extremely important.
Yes, and we do that. Also, we go into the schools to also educate the youth about, as you just mentioned, about voter registration. We are also participating every year up until this past year. Mm-hmm. We participated with the back to school giveaway, mm-hmm, in Gary, whereby we would have the Colgate bus present to offer free screenings to the youth in the area. We also would give away kits. This year, we had what we call a new initiative for a dental kit, Bright Smiles. We gave away over 1,200 dental care kits.
Wow.
To students at Thea Bowman, as well as Lake Ridge School District in Gary. We also gave those schools, because of the pandemic, we gave them face masks.
Yeah.
And it was personalized with their school logo on it. We know the kids are, people are getting used to wearing face masks, and we wanted to add that special touch for the students. So we also had the school logos put on the face mask. Again, we are in the arts, as what Keisha just mentioned. We just finished, how can we bring culture to the area, along,
mm-hmm,
with Westside Theater Guild,
yes,
the Hammond Academy that's out there, Performing Arts Academy. We also want to say, how can we bring culture? So this year, our arts chairs have been very, very busy. They have bought two film festivals. The last one we just did was on Black art, as far as educating the community. We're real big on health awareness, as it relates to breast cancer awareness, healthy heart, walking initiatives. And this year, please be on the lookout. We are doing something special for our men this year. We're having a prostate cancer event.
Where they can sign up for screening?
Yes, they can sign up for screening. And
now,
this is dedicated to our, more geared towards the men, although
yes,
it's open to the public.
But now the trick is going to be getting them there, right? So we're,
yeah,
going to have to disguise it as something else.
we have some good things that they'll be looking forward to.
Okay.
And
well,
one thing too, Madam President, is the health and human services with working with the kids.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was a great initiative that we were on the lookout for doing last year, but we didn't get an opportunity because of the pandemic. And that was a piece on bullying,
mm-hmm,
right? A lot of kids are being affected right now by bullying,
yes,
and
mm-hmm,
bullying leads to sometimes succumbing to their own lives.
Exactly.
Right?
It can lead to suicide.
Yeah.
It can lead to them leading lives of crime,
yeah,
after,
yeah,
they've been treated a certain way.
Yeah.
Then they, in turn,
yeah,
reenact those types of actions to other people. So,
yeah,
mm-hmm,
so if you are just tuning in and you've heard all of these things, she has so many things she's involved in, she's getting choked up. They're doing so much with the links. See how I'm trying to link myself in? They're the chapter of links. Incorporated are doing all these things, and so this is why you need to support the Derby. So for every program that she has listed, the dollars will help support these initiatives. Keisha, the scholarships.
Yes.
It was like, what, $100,000 or something over the past few years that you already talked a little bit more about the dollars raised.
So the monies raised from the Kentucky Derby will benefit scholarships and also our programs. We mentioned the different facets that we work with that are pouring out into the communities, right? Okay. So the monies that we raised, the over $100,000 that we've raised in this 10-year span have also contributed to the success of those programs.
Oh, that is awesome.
So it is wonderful. Yeah. And you know, we've had some great kids locally benefit from our scholarships. And what it does is it allows them to persist and continue with their education.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times kids don't have access to monies, to dollars.
Yes.
And that's a problem.
And but what I really love about this conversation is that a lot of people know you for the scholarship piece, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But Ms. Pritchett was able to outline all of the other initiatives that I'm hoping will draw more people in to say, I mean, scholarships are amazing, we know that, but to know that you're actually in the schools, providing programming, providing supplies, and being visible and consistent, and not just saying, okay, once a year we're gonna put our hats on and look cute. Mm-hmm. We do look cute for the record. But to be active and to have so many women who are committed to the mission, and you all, I know a lot of links, and you all are very committed. So that leads me to my final question before we recap the entire event. There may be someone watching who says, I want to get involved, I want to wear a hat, I want to have a link sister. I know the membership drive is kind of exclusive, it's not just click and sign up, but at least to get more information about perhaps being invited, how does that work?
And I'm going to yield to the president.
Because it may be like,
that's a presidential
if you don't question. Get a secret envelope stand under your door, then maybe it's not for you. But how can I prep myself to potentially be asked?
Well, one of our core values is friendship.
Okay.
And that's what, you know, I would tell anyone, please, you know, come out to our events.
Mm-hmm.
That way you can interact and network with our members. And basically, like as I just stated, one of our core values is friendship. And that's what we look for. As well as service, we look for friendship.
Okay.
And that's key. Those are our two pillars that we operate on. Again, mm-hmm. Membership is by invitation only.
I like that.
And
that means you can sift through the pile and make sure you're getting like the people you have. It speaks volumes of worker bees, leaders, and people who love this community. That's, to me, the common denominator I see with your organization.
And then you're exactly right. It's we look for service, and that should come natural. And just from all of us are involved with other organizations,
mm-hmm.
but we are committed to the mission of the Links. To basically transform our communities. And I want to touch on one thing, and even as we talk about the scholarship and what Linkeisha just mentioned, was our scholarship recipients receive a 4-year award. So we have, we basically award about $5,000 a year, and that's consecutive years for each recipient.
And what guidelines or criteria do they have to meet for it to continue to be renewed? What do they have to do?
So as long as they have to still maintain our GPA, which is 2.8,
I believe it is.
Okay. It's our GPA. We academics is big for us, as well as meeting the financial needs.
Okay.
And then we also, you know, look for what type of service is that student doing in the community? How are they giving back?
Nice.
And that's one thing, you know, because of most college applications, they're always asking, what's your community service now?
Mm-hmm.
And so we look for those qualities in the young people that we select for our scholarship. We just finished our round of actually seeking applicants.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're in the review process for our upcoming year, and that's why this fundraiser is so important, to make sure that we have the funds and continue to have the funds to support and get our students ready for college, as well as vocational, as well as if they decide to go into the military. We want to be there as an arm to help those students.
That is awesome.
Transformational. That was a great word.
Yes.
Transforming community.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I can't get out of here without talking about your attire. So, you know, I know people are stopping on my page like, what are they doing? You know, when you just happen to scroll down Facebook and you see these fancy hats, like, what is going on? Well, although the Derby is going to be virtual, that doesn't stop us from dressing the part, right?
No.
So, Keisha, you want to start first with this fantastic fascinator
you're wearing? So, this is my fascinator. It's second year adorning it, and I won't be wearing it again after such, right?
Okay.
But I'm just joking. But, yes, we do come, dressed the part. Had it been like a regular Derby, you would see hats looming from A to Z, dresses looming from 1 through 30.
Ooh,
you would see
wow.
the whole gamut. My present here, she's dressed.
Right, that's why we put her
she's
in the
dressed.
Middle.
She is certainly dressed the part today.
Yes.
I just threw my fascinator on just to give it an illusion that I'm at the Derby.
Right.
Holding my water.
Okay.
Didn't say it, just holding water. Okay, yeah, water. But she's really adorning the look for the Kentucky Derby.
But you know, that says for me, Alicia, that your commitment, again, speaks volumes to, of course, obviously the ladies in the organization have day jobs, families, other commitments.
Okay.
They belong to sororities. They are heads of their own organizations.
Yeah.
But yet and still, you all consistently show up on behalf of the young people in our community.
Yeah.
How cool is that?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you want to give? Tell us how to give again.
Well, there are multiple ways to give. We have a Facebook page that you can always send a message or leave a message and someone can return the message to you. We have a Northern Indiana Links website. Just type in Northern Indiana Links and you'll go right to our page. We have information on our GiveSmart that you can type in to get the $25 admission ticket.
Mm-hmm.
And again, if you're interested in a raffle ticket, just contact any member. Again, if you don't know of a member, shoot us a message on our Facebook page.
I know all of them.
Absolutely.
They're lovely ladies.
Absolutely. So, you can stream any kind of ways to get information. Northern Indiana, northernindlinks.com is that website. Am I correct in saying that, Shay? Yes, Shay,
yes,
who's
we
our
have
PR
to get all
person.
All of our thumbs up from Shay to make sure
yes.
this message
northernindlinks.com is
yes.
where you need to go.
So and now, Alicia, with your way.
.org, I'm sorry.
Is this just for today, and you're going to hit us with something else on May 1st?
This is just for today.
Oh, lots of jobs.
This is just for today.
Teaser.
I know.
Teaser.
My mom is a hat-wearing person, but I wear hats for the Derby, and so this is just for today, just to show our audience we are ready for our Derby, so please get your Derby attire ready. We will be showcasing people, looking at their attire, we're always looking for the different types of, as Lankeisha just said, different types of hats. Like I said, if we were in person, we still want to do it the same way. We still want to showcase your attire from head to toe.
Yes.
So please get Derby ready. We have our drinks available as far as the Derby's always known for their drink.
Mm-hmm.
The
signature drink, and we would always have that in person. Although Tito's will be mixing up a special recipe for us for a Derby drink, as well as, as Keisha just said, you don't want to miss our added entertainment. It's our comedian.
And, love Damon Williams.
And DJ Vince. We, like I said, last year, even though it was 2 hours or 2.5 hours, it wasn't enough time. We were still partying after we went off. You are in for a real treat if you ever been in attendance with DJ Vince.
Well, let me ask you this. Will any of the ladies have like small group watch parties? I mean, that's how you all will be watching it.
We will, and we will still go by our guidelines as far as the number of people that we should have in attendance for our small groups. So our members know the guidelines that have been sent out by our national organization office, and we will adhere to those guidelines. But yes, it's just going to be a great time being in your home and the comfort of your own home.
Mm-hmm.
But we still want you to feel the Derby atmosphere that we have for the Derby, and it's all going for a great cause. Again, a great cause to help transform our community, especially as it relates to our youth in our community, and that's what we're so appreciative of our sponsors, our guests, our family, our friends, our partners. And we always are looking for partnerships, because partnerships means that it's a lasting, ongoing relationships. But we love our sponsors as well. And we, if you take a look at our website, you will see all of our partners and our sponsors out there on the website. And we would love to advertise your business. When you click on if you go to our website and you look at our sponsors, you click on that link, it automatically takes you to that sponsor's business,
right,
to their website. So you know, we want to make sure that we help promote our sponsors and our partners so they can continue to help
to
promote
work
us.
With you.
Yes.
Perfect. Well, I want to thank you for being my special guest today on this special edition of the CWIT session. My guests are our Madam President and our fundraising chair from the Northern Indiana Lynx Chapter Incorporated, having their Kentucky Derby event on Saturday, May 1st from 3 to 6. It's going to be virtual, and all of the information is located both on their website as well as the Facebook page, which we're broadcasting live from today, with the newest flyers out, with all the guidelines for the raffles. You can just take the Peloton bike raffle off of there. I'm winning the Peloton bike, so let's just scratch that. If I'm eligible, I don't even know if I'm eligible now. I've gotten so engrossed in the program. They're going to say, cheater, cheater. But no, you have heard all of the programs that the Lynx support. And so now we're asking for your support so that these amazing programs and initiatives in our community can continue. So we ask that you share this video, make sure you reach out to a Lynx member for your raffle tickets, and then jump online and purchase your general admission so we can party with DJ Vince Adams and be entertained by the one and only Damon Williams. Ladies, you have
I want to also mention, we also support International St. Boniface Hospital, and it was just featured recently on CBS News. So we also help support that hospital over in Haiti. So like I said, we do things globally. I just gave a snapshot of what we do and what we're involved in, but please go to our website and you can find and learn all that we're doing. And again, we invite all our friends and family, anyone that's interested, please attend our events. Thank you.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in to this CWIT session, and we will see you at the Derby.
Yes, see you there.
Did an amazing job on the